Hello, today we're going to talk about the item templates and the feature that allows you to copy an item template. So going through the process, you're going to start with inventory, setup. Below setup, you're going to have items, item templates. So we're going to open this form and we're going to bring up an existing template. Let's just use our finished goods. So here we have an existing template. We can open that template and we can see that these are the settings for that particular template. And you can go through and see the values for that template. So when you're creating templates for the first time, you're usually creating several. So it's a good idea and it's a good feature to have the ability to copy a template. So the first thing we need to do is go back and create a new template. So we'll click on the new button and it brings up this form and we can type in our template. And the description field is required. At this point, we can go to Tools, Copy Template, and find a template that we want to copy from. Alright, point out here, this template is associated with an organization. So it's going to carry that organization into the copy. And that's an important thing to remember when you're copying templates. You may not want that. So if you don't want this organization information in the template, then you're going to have to find a template that doesn't have it. So let's see if we can find one that doesn't have that. Here's one that doesn't. Let's just try that one. Alright, now we've got some capability here. We can overwrite existing ones. Now, since this is a blank template that I'm creating back here, all of this information is available. So I can append it or I can overwrite when it's not null. So I could keep that existing values if there were values in the template and only overwrite if there's not a value in there already. In this case, I'm just going to take the overwrite and I'm going to select all of the different attribute groupings and I'm going to apply that. And it's done. And then I save my changes. And now I have a template. Now, you'll notice it doesn't really show any values. So you have to do a save. Okay, and once you've done the save, it looks like that template didn't have much in it. Let's close it and open it back up. Sometimes that helps. Alright. Apparently someone created pretty much a blank template. But I can go back here and do another copy. And this time, let's go get a template that does have an organization associated with it, just so we can see what happens there. Alright, now we can see there are values that have been copied. And you'll also note that the organization's been copied. And the problem here is that once that organization gets copied, then you can't really change it. So make sure when you're copying templates that you either do want or don't want this organization field in there. So at this point I can save it, and it's going to ask me which organization I want. And the save is complete, and now my template reflects the same values that are associated with the template that I copied from. And I can even prove that by going to the template that I copied from and showing you that. Same values. So that completes the process on how to use the copy template feature.